Say probably the biggest game of the weekend. We're off to Stamford Bridge. It's Chelsea at +160, Arsenal +165. Chelsea coming back off an absolute drubbing on the south coast at Brighton. Arsenal last away game was also on the south coast, and they were very underwhelming in a 1-1 draw against Southampton. The draw is at +240. I think some will be interested in that. Chelsea at +145, Stinch to score twice. But Arsenal at +150 to score twice. I think this is one of them. Pick your poison and you're going to be paid well.
Yeah, this is the biggest fence-sitting match of the season for me. Like, the market can't split them on the money line, and the market can't really split them on the goal line either. And neither can I. There's nothing I really want to get stuck into here. I mean, if you said to me, when we talk about betting Arsenal away from home, don't we, at like minus money, can we trust them? You know, they're almost favourites away at Chelsea. And you know, it wasn't so long ago that they went years without a win away at the Big Six, especially at the back end of the Arsene Wenger era. But obviously Arsenal went here in, I think it was April, and put four past Chelsea. So I don't think they've got any, you know, they're not scared of them or you know, that sort of, they've got a different mentality. I don't think they play within themselves. They've obviously got a much more better plan in place. They've got a very much more settled 11, whereas Chelsea are struggling a little bit with injuries, particularly defensively. They're really missing Reece James at that right wing back slot. They're playing players out of position. And they've lost their way a little bit under Potter. They started quite well under him. You know, they had a very good process. They were restricting the opposition. They were creating chances themselves. That seems to have gone out the window recently. And yeah, I think I'd always want to side with a team that you know that they're going to have a settled 11 and you can count on certain players contributing to the scoreline. Like I couldn't count on any of those Chelsea players, to be honest, in terms of regularly scoring, whereas Arsenal, you know, you've got Jesus, Saka, Martinelli, Odegaard, you've got that settled front four that have all clicked quite well. You've even got lads coming off the bench and Nketiah and Reece Nelson that are contributing to the scoreline. So having said all of that, that's already factored into the price in my mind. So I think the prices are absolutely right. Arsenal will have one fewer day's rest with playing in Europe on Thursday night, trying to wrap up finishing top of that Europa League group to make things a little bit easier for them in the next stage. So they might have to play some players that perhaps they prefer to rest, so that could come into it. But again, this is Sunday lunchtime, so maybe there is a big enough rest, and Arsenal are at home, so they weren't having to travel away in Europe. I don't know. I think I'm waffling a bit now. Mark might have a bit more of a stronger opinion than me.
Yeah, you're waffling, man. You're waffling because you didn't mention that Chelsea at +160. And by the way, I thought the big stat you was going to come out with. I cannot remember Arsenal winning a football match at odds of over something like +130, 145. I cannot remember. It used to be an old stat that Arsenal only ever won when they were odds on or around +105. Nothing higher than that. I'm so pro-Chelsea here, Marco, here. But also, I like the under 2.5 at -105. I think this could be a really, really tight game, but I think Chelsea may just have the quality. I want to go with the home side. You give me Chelsea at +160. After what happened last week, I've got to take the big money on the home side.
If there's space alongside Stinch on that fence, I'd like to join him if possible. Because
I'll tell you what, the one thing about the space on the fence is now putting the fence under pressure. I mean, it'll look like a wooden hammock.
But yeah, I mean, if I had to, I'd probably oppose you, Flash. But I think the price, the market is already sort of factoring in why I would be pro Arsenal rather than pro Chelsea. There's no fear factor with Arsenal playing Chelsea these days. They used to be. They've beaten them in three of the last four meetings. They've been to Stamford Bridge and won on the last two trips there as well. So they'll be confident. And as Stinch says, there's a sort of tried and trusted team sheet there, which we know what we're going to get. And midfield has been a real area of strength for Arsenal, as has their defence. Going forward, obviously, too, you know, all over the park, they've been very strong. Whereas Chelsea, they were bullied in their midfield by Brighton last weekend. They didn't offer a huge amount of protection. And yeah, it's not being square pegs. Well, it has been square pegs in round holes for a lot of the time, and Potter's still very much got a team in transition there. So whilst they're still playing Cucurella or Shalabar at centre half in a back three, or utilising Sterling as a wing back, I'm quite happy to sort of not be on the Chelsea bus too much, particularly in these big games. And you know, if you look at just raw numbers, Chelsea have scored 17 Premier League goals this season. Arsenal have scored 30. That's a huge difference. You know, only three of Chelsea's opponents have been in the top eight so far this season, so their schedule's been okay. Arsenal have scored twice or more in 9 of 12. They've scored three or more on 6 occasions. Chelsea have scored 2 goals or more in only 6 of 12, but only once have they scored 3 goals or more. So, you know, you look at the XG, or expected points, Arsenal are ranked second, Chelsea are ninth. If you look at the open play stats, Arsenal are almost within touching distance of Manchester City so far this season. Chelsea are way back in mid-table again. So, again, team news. Arsenal have close to a full squad available to them. Chelsea without Kante, Fofana, James, Chilwell now, possibly Kepa and Koulibaly as well after picking up Knox in midweek. So I can see why the market is favouring Arsenal quite heavily here, but ultimately I don't want to back them at those kind of prices in a big game away from home. There still is those kind of trust issues you have, but yeah, I can understand why Chelsea are quite a big price here because of everything I've just talked about.
Yeah, but it was only 2 weeks ago that I saw Arsenal go to Southampton, probably one of the worst and weakest sides in the Premier League, and draw 1-1 and actually could have lost the game. I mean, listen, it was one of those, but you're going to give me... Hold on a minute. What is this? Tell me. If Loftus-Cheek starts, then Chelsea will face a problem. Yeah, I think he's been very, very... He's been messed around a bit because he plays in three or four different positions. But also, yeah, I don't see him playing to his full potential, or he's just not good enough for Chelsea. But at Chelsea, them prices at plus 160, I'm not going to look a gift horse in the mouth. But I also think that around minus 105, I don't see free goals. I mean, that may give me a little bit of insurance policy of the 1-1 draw. I mean, the draw is obviously a runner, but I'm just going with the home side at plus 160. Remember, this is a Chelsea side that, when they wasn't playing well, went 2-0 up at half-time. They go 2-0 up in this game, then I'm not seeing Arsenal come back. So I'm going to go with the home side, and hopefully they can turn it around. Let's have a little look at the official picks, please. Oh, on my own. Flam like that. Mark, where are you? Come on. Come on, Chelsea, money line at plus 160. It's massive. Obviously, it might be a lineup check and we might steam in. And if there is any problems with the Arsenal lineup, then we're going to get a lot less than the plus 160 there.